Hello and welcome to another stream. My name is Dre and it is Learning Korean Day 160. Thanks for tuning in. Yeah, we start right away. Yesterday we finished every chapter except... Was it one or was it three? I'm not sure. I think only one. I think there was one chapter left. Yeah, pretty sure. Yeah, one chapter. I remember. Yeah, being sick in Korea. Okay, so that's what we'll do today. But before we go into that, of course, we go to memorize for the vocabulary review. Okay. Yeah, let's do it. Only five words here. Let's go. Okay, to hide oneself. Okay, so to lay down is like nota. To hide oneself. This was a sum. Was it sumda? I think it was actually sumda.
Sumda. Yeah.
My layout. Okay. To be loud. Okay, loud related to being shy. Shy. Pugerobda. Loud. Shigerobda. Nice. To be caught, kolida. Kolda? Kolida? I'm not sure which one it is. I mean, I could just try, but I want to think about it first. Is it Kolida or is it Kolda? I think it's Kolida. I think Kolda is to hang. I will go with Kolida.
Kolida.
Nice. To turn off. There was goda, but I think this is the active form goda.
Goda.
Yeah. Okay, so that was the review. Gojida is to be turned off. Gojida. Okay. Yeah, that was the review. So now let's go in the lesson. So, quick review from yesterday. We learned about compound words. Nothing too special here, I think. To bring can be two different words depending on the perspective. Okay, all good. And what else do we have here? Oh yeah, this was this general topic about... Yeah, it's hard to have a specific English translation. One word can mean many words, but if you really are open to it, you can combine all of these translations under an umbrella translation, and they are not so different after all if you're a bit open for it. This whole talk, I think this was in here. And it is also in the next one, in this homonyms. A lot of that discussion there. Then we had different, similar, same. Yeah, the particle that we use for those is gua or gua or rang irang. Hago. Ah yeah, and then we have this this thing about different and another. I'm different than him, I saw a different movie, another movie. Yeah, so okay, that was in there. And then we have some more words that have multiple meanings, like suda. And kolida. Okay. Yeah, so that's what we learned yesterday. And now we have the last chapter for this lesson, which is called Being Sick in Korea. One of the things people often try to learn first when learning a new language is how to express themselves in the event they have to go to the doctor. This is something that wouldn't fit into any specific lesson, so I want to cover it here. You already know the word apda, being sick or being injured or hurt, which you can use to indicate that you are sick or sore in some place. Okay. In English, sore and sick mean slightly different things. Yeah, sick is more like inside and sore is more like an outside wound. Okay, but in Korean it's the same. It's an adjective. Yes. And for some reason, I and ga are used. Okay. Pega apayo. Pega apayo.
Pega apayo.
Pali apayo.
Pali apayo.
Oh, pari, not pali. Pari apayo.
Pari apayo.
저는 어제 너무 yeah, some reason. Yeah. 저는 어제 너무 아팠어요. 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 저는 어제 너무 아팠어요.
저는 어제 너무 아팠어요.
아팠어요. 너무 is very. 어제 is yesterday, and this is the past conjugation of 아프다. Okay. Also, you can use the word 걸리다 to indicate that you have some sort of disease or sickness. You learned a little bit about 걸리다 in the previous section. This usage of 걸리다 essentially has the same meaning that was described in all the other examples. 걸리다, I am caught in a sickness. Okay. Korean people use this the following way. I caught a cold. So I was caught in a cold. Okay. Feels weird if you translate this the way I just did, literally. It feels weird that it's past tense, to be honest, because if I caught a cold, I still have it. I'm still caught inside of the cold. Like, if it's still the same. If I'm talking about the past and I'm healthy again, then of course it makes sense. But if I still have it, it feels weird to have the past form here. Okay, anyways. 저는 독감에 걸렸어요. 저는 독감에 걸렸어요.
저는 독감에 걸렸어요.
Notice how er is used in the sentences due to Kolidar having the nuance of being stuck in something. Okay. Also note that even oh yeah, okay, now he's going over the tenses, okay. Even though you have a cold in the present tense, Korean people use the past to express that they currently have a cold. Okay. Ki Chim and Jae Chaegi, although not originally nouns of Chinese origin, are both nouns where you can add hada to get the respective verb form, to cough or to sneeze. Okay. Chowe Adel Adelin Ad Adelin Adelin Chowe Adelin Shigerop Ge Shigerop Ge Shigerop Da Shigerop Da to be loud. My son coughed loudly. Loudly, adverb. Shigeropta. Seems like I've forgotten about adverbs. I just remember for hada verbs, hada adjectives, you can often use he instead of hada. But I can't really remember the ge right now. Shigerop ge. Weird. Let me actually check that out very quickly here. Where is it? Where are the adverbs? Was it even before this? Oh, lesson 8, okay. Korean adverbs. Yeah. Arrived in Korea today, okay. What degree? I think this one is the one we want to check. Oh, here we have it. Oh yeah, okay. Here we have it. Adding gate to the stem. Okay. So then it makes sense. So again, Joe Adarin Shigeropge Ki Chim Hesoyo.
저의 아들은 시끄럽게 기침했어요. 저의 아들은 시끄럽게 기침했어요. 저의 아들은 시끄럽게 기침했어요.
기침했어요.
저의 아들은 시끄럽게 기침했어요.
I think this syllable is pronounced very weirdly.
저의 아들은 시끄럽게 기침했어요.
저의 저의 왜
저의 아들은 시끄럽게 기침했어요.
저의 Okay, probably not naturally translated to my son was coughing loudly. Korean people don't distinguish between simple and progressive past tenses. Between simple and progressive, okay. You'll learn about progressive tense in lesson 18. Okay. Wow, that's a long lesson. I apologize for writing these lessons so long. These lessons could have been easily broken into two, three, or seven, seven, four separate lessons. But it chose against doing it that way when I was first learning Korean. I wanted to plow through material as fast as possible, as fast as I possibly could. And I guess that is coming out as I'm writing these lessons as well. Yeah, but we have hope. Now that he's actually realizing it at the end of this lesson, we can hope that the future lessons are a bit smaller. But I don't think so. I lost hope, to be honest. Okay, I got it. Take me to the next lesson, or click here for a workbook to go along with this lesson. Thankfully, I already have that. Okay, yeah, that was the lesson. So, shall we go into the exercise, or should we do anything else? I think we are ready, right? That was just the basics. Now let's check out the real grammar lessons. Okay, let's see exercise. I'm opening it here. 1 second. Okay, there I have it. Okay, lesson 10, 11, still 11, 9 to 12, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Here we are. Lesson 15. Use the following three words in the appropriate sentences below. 쓰다, 걸리다, 들다. Okay. So this one is to use to write to wear a hat. This one is like to be caught. And this one is to turn, right? I hope. Not sure about this one, to be honest. Oh no, it's to carry, to hold, or to enter, to go into something. To turn was toll then. Yeah, toll da. Okay. This one is tilda. Well, close enough, right? Not really, but. Okay, so it is. To hold, like to hold your hand up, for example, to hold something, to carry something, and to enter, to go into something. So that's tilde. Okay, so let's do it now. Okay. By the way, this German here, for anyone who is not German and seeing this, it's saying please insert text here, or please enter text here. Actually, it's only enter text here, without the please. Okay, so now first we should read the sentence maybe. 저는 어젯밤, last night, yesterday night. Enter is here. No, it's another order. Here is here. This is here. Then text is text, and eingeben ist enter. So it's the literal translation is here, text, enter, but it's just another order of words in German. Okay. So yesterday night I jump, sleep, fast or quickly. So yesterday, sleep quickly. What fits? I got caught in the sleep quickly. I entered sleep quickly. I used sleep quickly. Yeah, I think we learned that in the lesson, and it should be I entered sleep quickly, right? Is it enter or is it to be caught? I think it was enter. So I would say tilde, which we use informal high respect conjugation, and it looks like we have to figure out the tense from the context. So this was yesterday night, so it's definitely past tense. So that was not Korean. So we have this, but we have to conjugate to the past tense. This is an irregular. Yeah, okay. We remove the So we remove the da, of course. We remove the Actually, I'm not sure. Ah, damn it. Do we really remove it? So it could be this, or it could be this, I guess. I guess one of those is correct. And I'm not super sure because I thought the R irregular is saying you remove the R, but then you have an Ö in the end, but and like that's also an irregular then. It also needs to get removed. You can't combine the Ö with the O from Osoyo. So I'm not 100% sure if you even remove the R. Not an irregular. Okay. Yeah. This feels definitely more natural. I guess the R irregular is the only one that is not always applied when you add the vowel. The R irregular is only applied when you add specific things, right? And just a vowel in the next letter is not triggering the R irregular. But of course, to be 100% sure, we do a very quick check here. Bam. Very quickly. R irregular. Okay, only when we add those things. No, wait. You must choose. Okay. If the final letter is an R and you add one of the following. Okay, so only if we add those, then we do it. Only if we add those, then the irregular applies. Okay. Then let's go back. Wait, is the past of yes, I think so. Did da also not also there was a very good chapter. I actually had a Korean here who got confused in the chat. Let me show you. This is an interesting part between the words ditta and tilda. No, drosso. To listen and to hear. Ditta and I'm not sure. Drabuda. One second, we can get this. Listen. Where is it? I thought it was here. Wait, I want to find this. I really want to find this now. Ah, here. Okay. Here we have it. Okay, so but let's check this out. Here we notice that you need to consider the following irregular pattern: the D irregular and then the R irregular, because it ends in the final vowel. Okay, the R irregular is not really impactful, but yeah. Let's quickly check what the R irregular is. Irregular when the final letter you cannot, instead you must look at the vowel in the second last syllable. Okay, but if there is no second last syllable to check the vowel, we just use or, I think. Let's see here. Jamgeda. So here we look at the vowel here at the jam. So we add a. And then we remove the er and just merge it. Okay. But sometimes there is no second last syllable at all. Yeah, here. If we need to look at the second last syllable, but there is none, so or. Yeah, okay, so I was correct. So in case there is no previous syllable, we just add or. Okay, so now let's go to the thing I want to show you. Where is it? Where is it? Here. So the dictionary form is tutta, but the conjugated forms have an R inside, but then there's the dictionary form tilde, and even Koreans confuse those sometimes. Yeah, because this looks, yeah, this is basically the same. It's the same. So I was, when I learned this, there was a Korean in the chat, and I was learning the vocabulary, and I was like, ah, to hear, that was ditta, I think. And then he was, no, it's with an R. But I was learning the dictionary form, so it was ditta, but he meant it was tilde. So that was a bit weird. Anyways, I think we have enough here. I just want to check one more thing. Töter. Okay. Yeah, I don't know. It's a bit weird. Maybe it was in lesson 6 or so, because I learned Töda by itself already, I think. Maybe not. Okay, I guess I didn't. Whatever. Okay, so let's go back to the exercise here. So the R is not in regular because we are not adding one of those four things that were mentioned in the lesson. So it's just Dorosoyo. Dorosoyo. Okay. So now let's go for the next one. Joe Sajinin, so Joe Sajinin, Chimde. Wait, what? Buye. Oh, that is, we is. In front or above? I think in front. Okay, so my picture, so is such in picture. I think so. My picture. In front of my bed or above my, okay, then it's probably above my bed. Okay, so what is the picture? Above the big, above the bed, what is the picture doing? It's hanging there, right? It's clearly hanging there. It's caught on the wall there. So it's Collida in my opinion. Col. Kolida. Now we conjugate, we remove the da. So it is hanging currently, so I think we use the present form. Is it a state? It is in the state of hanging on the wall. Why not? Kolyoisoyo. Kolyo. Kolyo isoyo. Yeah, I think that's correct. What do you guys think? Do you guys agree? Or am I wrong here? I also think the same. Okay, nice. Okay, next one. Aderin, so son, my son. Omare, Mother. Wie Paxere. What? Why are there two objects here? I'm a bit confused. Adrin, Omare, we have Pax. What is Paxere? I don't know what this is. Paxere. Konglish. Okay, wait then. Paxere. 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 No, I have no idea. Box. Okay. Ah, Paxe. Paxe. That's box? Okay, wow. Ah, man, always these words that I have not learned yet in these exercises. Can't believe it. But to be honest, I think I learned box already. But not that word, another word. I think I learned another word for box. Like, Sangja? Also, I'm not sure, but let me see. Sangja, Sangja, yeah, here it is, Sangja box. Always these new words in the exercises. I can't believe it. Every time. Okay, and Omare wihe means foreman. Foreman. Like, am I so bad at remembering or have I not learned that? I'm not sure. Like, wihe? I can't remember. I don't think you learned it. Yeah, it's crazy, right? How am I supposed to do these exercises if I have not learned parts of the sentences that appear here? I mean, I have learned four. But let me actually check. So, thanks for the follow, Happy Box. Thank you. Let me go back here. I learned four already. I think here in lesson 12. From and to. Okay, then it was lesson 13. Here I learned it. Four. Doing something for somebody, for with the benefit of. Ah, we have. Damn, I actually learned it. Wow. I work hard for the company. We sare, we have. Damn. That's unfortunate for me. Okay. We have. We have, okay, we have four. Okay. Okay, so, the son box for his mother. Okay, what did he do with the box? He wrote a box, he used a rock a box, he wore a box. No, he was caught in a box. He entered a box. He carried a box. He carried a box. That makes sense, right? So, yeah, I think that's it. So, but wait, he is probably carrying right now. We don't know if it's past tense or not. So I will, since we had past tense here already for sentence two, I will do present tense this time. Not that it's like super different, but yeah, okay, we go with that, I think. Okay, next one. Georgi Buton. Soul Gaji. So from Yogi, from here to Seoul. To what is to? Okay, that's two, the number two. Okay. Tushigan, so 2 hours and 30 minutes. Pun only. Only 30 minutes. Okay, only man. Man is only. So from here to Seoul, it's only 2 hours 30 minutes. Yeah, and we learned it in the lesson when people are saying such times that you need to go from one place to another place. Koreans actually like to say, "2 hours and 30 minutes are caught." From here to Seoul. So I would go with Kolida here. Kolida. Now we translate it. So Kolyoyo. Kolyoyo? Sounds weird. Kolyolo. Kolyoyo. Kolyoyo. Yeah, but I think it's correct. It's just hard to pronounce, to be honest. Kolyoyo. 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 I want to say Kolyoyo. 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 Okay. Yeah, it's probably just me. Okay. Chonin. Sutka Ragil. Sutgarak? Wait, so Karak is usually like it appears in words where you have many things that come from another thing. For example, fingers, we have son karak, fingers. The fingers are coming from the hand. Hand is son, and son karak are the fingers. And the same for hair. We have mori karak. Mori is the head, and karak are the many hairs coming from the head. But I don't know what Sut is. Sut karak. Maybe sut is like foot, and sut karak is something like. Well, I to be honest, I don't know the English word. The fingers on your foot, basically. But Jotkarak and Sutkarak. Not this time. Damn. Could be t ah toe. Toe is the English word. Yeah. Pal. So Pal is foot. Yeah. Okay. I just know Shinbal. I don't know Jotkarak. The only Karak words I have are hair, fingers, and I think that's it. Only those. Chopstick. Chopstick. Okay. Ah, it's a spoon. Okay, so Karak is also used for things you eat with. Not sure what the English word is for that. I know the word dishes, but that includes the plates, right? The tools that you eat with, do they have an they probably have cutlery. I thought cutlery is only like knives and so on. Everything that you use to cut something. Is a spoon also cutlery? Okay. Yeah, so again we learned something about English, or I learned something about English. Spoon is also cutlery. Okay. Then I know a new word. And I also learned a new Korean word once again. So again, another word that I have not been introduced to yet. Crazy. Okay, so let's do the sentence now. Chonin Sudkaragil Mail every day. So I spoons every day. I use spoons every day. Probably, yeah, right? What else can you do with spoons? I don't get caught in them. I don't enter them. I don't. Well, I carry them, maybe. Yeah, I carry spoons every day. I would rather say I use spoons every day. That feels like the more common sentence, right? Yeah. Okay, so we have Söda. Which becomes Soyo. Right? Jotkarak and Sutkarak is often shortened with the word Sujo. Sujo. Okay. Sujo. Yeah, because those are the two most common cutlery items that you use in Korea, right? So, is this correct? Soyo? Soyo? I agree. Okay. Okay, then let's do the next one. Chonin Oje Se Seroun 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 Seroun. Set up da conjugated to a adjective describing the following noun. Seroun. And set up da is new, right? Okay, so yesterday I did something with a new Kilope? What? Killer Bay? Okay, wait. So, since there is this special K in the beginning, that's usually an indication it's Konglish. Let me try to figure this out. So the Ö is often not there in the English. So it could be Klop. Klop? Klop? Is it Klap? Klap? Klop. Klap. I will say Klap. It's correct, Klap, okay. Okay, so again. I was in a new club yesterday. Dungari, I thought Dungari is more like a school club or so. A club where you are together with some people in a school or so, where you do the same hobby or so, and not really a club where you dance. But okay, maybe they actually mean that. Yeah, right. I'm thinking about the club that you dance in, but yeah, I think you would use enter here. Yeah, I think here they mean the dancing one, and Dungari is the school university club or group, yeah. So in this case, I would say I entered a new club yesterday. I went into a new club yesterday. And because of that, I would use tilde. And since it is happening yesterday, or it was happening yesterday, we will conjugate this to the past, which should be this. Okay, next one. Uri. Äginen. Ägi is a baby, I think, right? Our baby yesterday. Kamgie. Cold. Our baby was caught in a cold yesterday. Our baby caught a cold yesterday. So Kolyosoyo. Kolyosoyo. Okay. Yeah, so what do you guys think? Are the last two correct? 7 and 8? I'm feeling pretty confident about those. Should be okay. Nice. Okay. Then the last one. Chonin Nail. Nail. Is this tomorrow? Yeah, it's tomorrow. Nail. Yeah, tomorrow. Okay, so I tomorrow. Joe Yoja. Yoja Chingure, my girlfriend. We have 4 Sarang Pyongyi. I mean, we learned some words with Sarang, but I can't remember Sarang Pyon. Oh wait, there's still some discussion about number 7. Ah, okay, so you're saying for 7 you like a compound word better, but I don't think that's what they look for here. I mean, yes, sure, if you just want to translate the sentence. I guess you could say the same with Gada, but I don't think that's the point of this exercise. So in the context of this exercise, I think we don't use a compound word. We just use the word itself. But in general, of course, yeah. So Sarang Pyeongji is probably something like wedding. I mean, we had. No, wait. No. No, wait. I'm wrong here. Sarang. Sarang is love. Pyeongji. Yeah, okay, good. So I know Nampyeon. Nampyeon is a husband, right? So Sarang Pyeongji is probably wedding. Ah, Pyeongji, oh, a love letter. Okay. Love letter. Pyeongji, right. It's letter. Yes, I learned that before. So, yeah, my mistake. Okay, love letter. And hi, Doki-san, by the way. So, I will write a love letter to my girlfriend or for my girlfriend tomorrow. So we use seda, but we will conjugate it to the future form, so it will become se koyeyo. I am the thing that will write a love letter to his girlfriend tomorrow. Should be correct. Spoiler, I hope she don't see the stream right now. No, she's busy. But she's ex actually outside of this room here. But yeah. Never mind. I don't think she can hear me. Yeah, I think that's it, right? So let's check the answers now. I will open the answers. One second. So that was lesson. What was it? Lesson exercise 16, okay. Okay, I got it. So let's do this. So number two I wrote Terosoyo. Terosoyo. Number two, Terosoyo. Okay. Number three, Kolyo isoyo. Number three, Kolyo isoyo. Perfect. With state. State, passive state. number four, teroyo. Number four, terosoyo. Okay. Terosoyo. The son carried the box for his mother. Yeah, okay, but I mean, how can you know it's past? He could currently carry it for his mother, right? There's like no indication that there's no yesterday or so in this sentence. So how would you know that it's past tense? What do you mean carried? Did I say carry? I mean, it was not in the exercise. I couldn't know that it's past tense from the Korean sentence, right? Yeah, I know it's past, but that was not in the exercise. So, I mean, I could not have known that when I did the exercise. I can see that here also in the solution it is past tense for the Korean, but there was no way of knowing it when we did the exercise. That's what I'm saying. So I wouldn't I would totally not count this as a mistake. Okay, number five, I wrote Kolyoyo. Number five, Kolyoyo. Number six, Soyo. Soyo. Number seven, Terosoyo. Number seven, Terosoyo. Number eight, Kolyosoyo. Number eight, Kolyosoyo. Okay. Number nine is the last one missing. Number nine, Sylkoyeo. Sylkoyeo. And it is Sylkoyeo. Okay, perfect. Yeah, so with that, this exercise ends. Everything is correct. With some of your help, of course. There were two things that I should have known that I forgot, but then there were also two things that I never learned before, and they are used here in this exercise. So, yeah, but overall, I think it was still fine. So that means tomorrow we go into the last thing that is remaining for lesson 15, which is the workbook. We did this now, and now that's it for this lesson, but not quite. We still have some videos here, practice videos about this lesson. So this practice video is what we will do tomorrow, depending on how fast we go through with it. We'll do the second one as well, but in my experience, I always think, yeah, 1 hour should be way enough to do two videos, right? But then we talk so much about the solution and so on that it just takes almost an hour to do one of them. So, yeah, I'm not sure. We'll see. Okay. Oh no, I can't be here the next days. Oh, what are you doing? I will miss the exercise. It's happening tomorrow, yeah. If you're not here tomorrow, yeah, the next 2 days, tomorrow and the day after tomorrow, that's where these videos are coming. Now that's unfortunate. But I think I should do them anyways. Yeah, I mean, you can look at them on the YouTube video, I guess. And then you will be here for the lesson 16 videos again. Oh, by the way, lesson 16 is the last one for the workbook I have. So that means here we have an exercise for lesson 16, but then we also have, well, it's not here. Okay, never mind. It is 1 second. Here, this one. Mini test. Lesson 9 to 16 mini test. We'll do that one after lesson 16. So if we completed lesson 16, we not only have the exercise in the workbook and the two practice videos, but we also have a mini test. So after lesson 16, we have a lot of stuff to do. But yeah, tomorrow will be the practice videos of lesson 15, and then we go into the vocabulary of lesson 16. Then unit 2. Yes, of course. No, never mind. It's still unit 1. Unit 1 goes until lesson 25. Here we have another like 8 lessons and a mini test. And after that, we also have the unit 1 test. So after lesson 25, we have not only the test for all the knowledge of lesson 17 to 25, but also the test for the whole unit. And then we have listening practice. And we have even a listening practice for the whole unit one. Wow. So after lesson 25, there will be so much practice to do. Oh, actually, never mind. I guess. Is it? I'm not sure. Let's see. Lesson 15. Listening practice. Play.
저는 좋은 김치를 먹었어요.
Wow. So is this separate from the YouTube video? I guess it is. I never saw this before. I never saw this before. Wait, let me see. I mean, we did the the lessons 14, right? We did that already.
이 값은 세금을 포함해요.
포함해요.
이 값은 세금을 포함해요.
값은 포함. I'm not sure. Let's see. I go to the practice video, listening practice of lesson 14.
Welcome to the lesson. Prompt you with 5 Korean sentences.
저는 책을 탁자에 놓았어요.
Okay, that's a different one. So it looks like we have a whole list of listening practice here that we never did. So yeah, we have a lot of stuff to do here, I think. I never saw that before. But this exercise is endless. Ah, you mean it combines all the different sentences that are in the lessons, right? Yeah, okay. What are theme lessons, by the way? Oh, wow, never mind. Okay, but we definitely have the unit one tests. The unit one test... the unit one test should be a pretty good test for all the knowledge of lesson one. Okay, so the plan is still tomorrow practice videos for lesson 15, then vocabulary 16, grammar 16, practice 16, then the test for 9 to 16, and then all the other lessons, and then we do the unit one test. It's all far in the future. We don't even have to talk about that now. So yeah, thanks for watching. That's it for this stream, and bye bye, annyeong. And yeah, Flo, see you on Monday. Have a great 2 days that you're not here. Bye bye.